Welcome to Superior Profit Weekly Market Roundup, 12th May 2018. I am Sagar Nandi, Chief Analyst and Trader at Superior Profit, a company based in Singapore. I will not take time to introduce myself. If you are interested to know more about me, the company Superior Profit, or more importantly, how it may help in your trading, you may visit the website superiorprofit.co and click on the About menu. Before we begin, we go through the standard disclaimer. This demonstration is for educational purposes only. It is designed to share information on Superior Profit's trading system. The information presented here should only be used by people who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. Past performance is no guarantee of future return. Superior Profit is not an investment advisor. This session is not for any recommendation of buying or selling stock or any other instrument. Superior Profit will have no liability for any investment decision made by its audience. As usual, in today's topics, we look at oil and gold, these two commodities, using technical analysis. They tend to impact related stocks. When the broad market goes up, it tends to take many stocks with it. That is why we keep an eye on the direction of the market. We study that using market breadth of NASDAQ and NYSE and also technical charts of the four broad market ETFs. Other than aligning our trades with the broad market, we like to take long trades in industries that are strong and short trades in industries that are weak. We can identify industries' strength or weakness by observing industry rotation that we study using industry scorecard and heat map. We'll do the same thing today to see which industries are strong and which ones are weak. Along the way, we may go through some of the trade examples from the Q forum and certainly try to look for potential trades for the coming week. That was the last slide of the presentation. We'll move to live system. We start our commodities analysis using oil. We are looking at oil ETF USO using weekly backdrop chart and daily hop-on chart. Together, they create a template. We call it at a glance template because it can help us decide if there is a low risk entry opportunity at the right edge of the chart in a few seconds. Oil is going up strongly. The weekly candles are cyan for 5 weeks now. At the end of last week in the daily chart, price was at this point. It had broken above the watermark resistance level with a cyan color candle. However, price was very close to upper boundary. Therefore, we would not take a long swing trade at that point. After that, price is continuing to close higher. On Friday, it has displayed a bearish headwind signal. There is no bearish headwind trade setup because it is not matching all the requirements for a short trade. Which requirements are not matched? One of them is that the weekly candle color is neither neutral and the shape is also not bearish. So the weekly candle is not meeting the requirements of headwind short trade setup. Also, in daily chart, we have a memory support line nearby that is too close to the closing price. That also doesn't allow us to take a headwind short trade at the close of Friday. There is no swing trade setup in US oil right now. We are now studying gold using the gold ETF GLD. we are using the same at-a-glance template. In the weekly chart, gold continues to remain in magenta, that is bearish color, though this week on a closing basis price went up. We can see that from the weekly activity bar being in green color. We also see that the weekly activity is very small relative to past many weeks. Therefore, it doesn't show enough bullishness in gold. The weekly candle shape is also indecisive, having both upper tail and lower tail. In the daily chart, earlier gold was near the lower boundary and it was also near the white direction line and watermark support at that point. These are robust support areas and it was expected that gold will recover somewhat. There was no long trade setup in gold. As is usual in an oversold instrument, gold recovered somewhat and on Friday came to value area, also near the declining yellow direction line, and dropped from there. At the right edge, it is inside a triangle pattern. We tend to avoid taking any swing trade when an instrument is inside triangle pattern. Therefore, there is no swing trade opportunity in gold also at this point. Now we are studying market breadth using Nasdaq Composite Index and NYSE Composite Index weekly charts. And three pairs of internals, new high low, advanced decline and up down volume. In terms of price, both the indices are continuing to be in uptrend. They will remain in uptrend until these memory support lines are broken. Last week, we observed that for two successive weeks at that time, we had candles with long lower tails. Both for Nasdaq and NYSE, the shapes were bullish. And both of those four candles came close to memory support lines and went up from there, showing that buyers were coming in at the memory support levels. That buying push continued this week. Both NYSE and Nasdaq ended with bullish cyan color candle and also bullish candle shape. NYSE couldn't go above the high of this candle 4 weeks ago, which had a long upper tail. It is still inside the range, whereas Nasdaq could go above the long upper tail candle. Nasdaq is clearly stronger than NYSE in terms of price move. What about the internals? In recent several weeks, new high low was not key to price moves. That has changed this week. Both for Nasdaq and NYSE, new high low went up and they closed above zero. All the other four internals, in fact, went down relative to previous week. Though most of them closed above zero, only up-down volume of Nasdaq closed below zero. That is a bit surprising, isn't it? The price moves are clearly bullish, so we would expect that the internals will all be bullish. However, they are not. It seems this week's price move is more influenced by the new high lows than by the other internals, which is different from what we saw in past several weeks. Overall, we have to conclude that the indices were bullish, and this week it became more bullish. Internals this week are neutral because four of them went down and five of them closed above zero. Let's see what is the conclusion that we can arrive at from the broad market ETFs. Now we are studying SPY S&P 500 ETF using Kew at a Glance template. Last week SPY was inside triangle pattern. This week it could break out of that. Therefore it is more bullish. However, weekly is now resting just below another memory resistance. Therefore, we'll be cautious and not attempt to take any long trade in SPY at this point. In terms of price move, it is bullish. Therefore, we will not take any short trade as well. What about QQQ? NASDAQ composite was more strong than NYSE composite, and QQQ is also stronger than SPY. There is no memory resistance in the weekly chart. There is further open space above current price. It's more likely that QQQ will continue to go up. In the daily chart, QQQ broke above the memory resistance on last Friday. It was the strongest ETF at that time. Since then, it has continued to go up. At the right edge, it is too close to upper boundary to give us a low risk long opportunity right now. And it is bullish, therefore we are not going to take any short trade. If QQQ pulls back little bit and goes up again, then it may give us a low risk go with flow trend following long trade setup. You may keep an eye for that. Dow Jones Industrial Average ETF DIA using at a glance template. Last week it was inside triangle pattern both in weekly and daily. This week it has broken above the triangle pattern in both the charts. There is no low risk entry opportunity right now. If DIA comes back little bit and then goes up again, then it may give us a low risk go with flow long trade set. IWM in the weekly chart, it was silent for many weeks. This week it has gone up strongly, and like SPY, it is closing right at the memory resistance line. In daily chart also, it is closing right below a memory resistance line. Therefore, we will not like to take any long trade in IWM right now. If IWM pulls back little bit and goes up again, it may give us a trend following go with flow long trade set. If we combine the information from market breadth analysis and the broad market ETF analysis, then we see that generally market is bullish. Composite indices as well as the ETFs, all of them are bullish. Some of the ETFs are at memory resistance levels, therefore we may not take a long trade in them. However, there is no bearish indication in any of the ETFs or the composite indices. So we have to conclude that overall the market is bullish right now. In this bullish market, what are the sectors and industries that may give us low risk entry opportunities? Let us study that using sector and industry analysis. Sector performance analysis. Every week we study 11 sectors across 3 review periods. Red bar represents performance of this week, green bar performance of 1 week before the red bar, and blue bar performance of 2 weeks before the green bar. Together they give us performance of 4 weeks or about 1 month of performance. Any bar coming to the right of the zero line indicates the sector went up. Any bar coming to the left of the zero line indicates the sector went down. Nine of the 11 sectors went up, and they went up by significant percentages, showing a bullish picture of the market. This is the same conclusion that we arrived at from market breadth and market ETF study. Information technology went up by almost 6%, industrials, energy, financials, materials, even healthcare. Many of them went up by significant percentages. Industrial sector is the second best performer. I had indicated this possibility in last market roundup based on acceleration of a large number of industries in this sector. We had studied that using QH in last market roundup. Many of the industries were accelerating at that time. As is often the case, it ended up being one of the best performers in this week. That is opposite to what happened in utilities. Utilities sector is the worst performer this week. In last market roundup, I had warned of utilities sector based on deceleration. That warning came true. For industrials and utilities, future moves were accurately predicted once again by Q score, acceleration and deceleration respectively, showing why traders take this acceleration deceleration signal seriously. Remember last week when we studied sector performance, we saw utilities was the only sector that was up for all the 3 review periods. For a common trader, it showed that utilities was strong. However, Q traders have more insight available from industry acceleration deceleration, and that showed that a large number of utilities industries were decelerating. Based on that, Q traders will be cautious and not like to enter new long trades. Instead, they will book profit in existing long positions or even look for potential shorts. We see that acceleration deceleration in play every way, like we see in real estate. In this way, real estate went up more than 2%. Earlier, we could catch the exact turning up of this sector using Q 360 degrees analysis. We had discussed that in earlier roundups. Now, though real estate went up, later on we'll see that many of the real estate industries, probably all of them, decelerated this week. This is not a time to take new long positions in real estate. If somebody has existing long positions, they may book or protect profit using Q trailing stop. We'll come back to real estate when we study the decelerating industries. Best performing industries of this week: best performing industries went up by between 7 to 16%. These are massive gains for a week. 5 of the 10 best performing industries are in information technology sector, and 3 of them are related to semiconductors. Information technology had been strong for a while, and it continues to be strong. As a sector, Infotech was the strongest sector, and that strength is reflected in many of its industries coming in the top 10 best performing industries. These are home entertainment, software, semiconductor equipment, semiconductors and semiconductor equipment, semiconductors and technology, hardware, storage and peripherals. 4 of the best performers, that is coal and consumable fuels, home entertainment software, semiconductor equipment and technology, hardware, storage and peripherals. These 4 industries were among the best performers in the last week as well. Therefore, knowing their strength, you could identify swing long trade opportunities, and you would probably do pretty well because they continued to be the best performers this week as well. In technology, hardware, storage and peripherals, 3D systems, DDD, went up by 20.6% this week. Very large gain. It had given a bounce long trade setup on 4th May, just after earnings. DDD had high short squeeze score that helped fuel the rally after the initial drop after earnings that resulted in a false downside breakout at both weekly and daily memory support levels. 3D systems gave us a very low risk entry opportunity, a stock where the industry was strong, it had short squeeze, and the technicals were very strong as well. At this time, let us have a look at QH. We'll look at DDD, but before that, let us take a look at the overall sectors and the best performing industries. Every time we open QH, it analyzes 11 sectors and more than 170 industries across 12 monthly review periods, and then more frequently over recent periods of 10 days, 5 days, 2 days and 1 day. For each of the periods, it assigns a low score of 1 to the worst performing item, high score of 11 for sectors for the best performing item, and assigns a heat map, magenta to the worst performer, cyan to the best performer, and a color gradient to all the items in between. The result is a scorecard and heat map that instantly tells us which sectors are strong now, infotech, industrials, which are weak now, utilities, telecom. And in addition, it tells us which ones were weak earlier and now strengthening, like industrials, and which ones were strong earlier and weakening now, real estate. We can infer all that using the scorecard and heat map in a few minutes. In fact, in few seconds. QH does a similar analysis for all the industries. To get the best performing industries, we can sort over the primary 5 days period just by double clicking on the column header. The best performing industries come to the top. We can see out of the 10 best performers, many of them are in information technology. The industry, technology, hardware, storage and peripherals, it had been strong for quite a long time. This week it continues to be one of the best performers. We can drill down to its stocks by clicking the drill down button, or we could use offline Q stock scorecard. To save time, let us use the offline Q stock scorecard. This is Q stock scorecard. It has data on more than 2000 liquid stocks of the USA market. It has data on the vital statistics and then many other information on each of these stocks. To analyze the stocks of a particular industry, we could filter by that. We see 3D Systems is a stock in this industry. It is not optimally valued. Valuation is coming in magenta color, showing that in terms of performance relative to its peers, it is already overvalued. Earnings growth is also not looking nice at all. It has negative earnings growth for all the recent yearly periods, year 1, 2, and 3, and as well as all the 3 recent quarters, current quarter, the one before that, and the second one before that. Fundamentally, DDD is not one of the strongest stocks. However, it had a short squeeze potential. Let's have a look at the technical charts of DDD. This is DDD using at a glance template. It had earnings 1 week ago. At that time, price tried to go below this memory support line, but reversed. That week ended with a very bullish shape candle. This week, it came to the same memory support line. The low of this week's candle precisely touched the memory support and then it went up with extreme high activity. In the daily chart, there was a memory support line at this point, which was broken on this magenta color candle that was at earnings, and price fell with extreme high activity. The very next day, price went up and closed above that memory support line, also with very high activity. If you look at the price levels of weekly and daily charts, you will see that the false downside breakout in the daily chart coincided with the point where weekly candle came to the memory support line and went up from there. Because it was bouncing up from memory supports of weekly and daily charts with very high activity, it was meeting all the requirements of a bounce long trade setup. Remember, bounce trade setup is applicable only when there is a sudden and sharp drop, not for usual swings of a stock. In DDD, the drop was sudden and it was not usual. It was related to earnings results, and those situations give us appropriate bounce trade setups, like it gave in this case. Since then, DDD has gone up sharply. Following discipline, half of the profit could be booked near value area. There was a memory resistance at this point, and remaining position could be held even now with trailing stop. We are now studying the worst performing industries of this week. Four of the worst performing industries are in consumer discretionary sector, and three of them are in retail. In last market roundup, I had warned of retail industries as 8 of the 10 most decelerating industries were in retail. deceleration once again accurately predicted future industry move. We saw this to be true for industrials, we saw this to be true for utilities, and now we see the same thing to be true for retail consumer discretionary industries as well. This is a snapshot of the most decelerating industries that we shared in previous market roundup. We saw that eight of the most decelerating industries were in consumer discretionary. Based on that, we would avoid taking any new long position, instead protect or book profit in long positions and look for potential shorts. That was useful analysis because this week many of the consumer discretionary industries became worst performing. Three of the worst performers are in utility sector. I had warned of this possibility in last market roundup based on utility sector's deceleration. That was pretty useful analysis as well. And it is very easy to carry out this acceleration deceleration analysis using QH or Q industry scorecard. Department stores is a stock that decelerated 1 week ago. It is one of the worst performers this week, and this stock, Dillard's, DDS, gave a trend following go with flow short signal on 3rd May that turned out to be a profitable trade. DDS short could also be taken on 30th April using the same go with flow short setup. Fundamentally, DDS is mid-valued. Its industry was weakening, decelerating when the technical trade setup came on 3rd May. Combining technicals, fundamentals and industry rotation, you could take the trade with confidence. That trade had a small risk as the stock level was near entry price. Let's study the worst performing industries from QH, then drill down to Dillard's, have a look at its fundamentals and also technicals. In QH, to get the worst performing industries, we can sort over the primary 5 days period. Just double clicking it, we'll get the worst performers to the top. Department stores. It immediately catches the eyes because it was strong earlier, cyan, and now smoothly transitioning to weakness, magenta color. Let's have a look at stocks of this industry using scorecard. In scorecard, we can filter for the stocks of department stores industry. We see many of them are optimally valued. We can sort over the valuation primary column by double clicking on the column header. We see only two stocks are not optimally valued. DDS is one of them. If we look at the yearly EPS growth, 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, all of them were negative. The latest quarter had positive growth. However, overall, if you look at all these stocks, you will see DDS is one of the weakest, both in terms of valuation as well as in terms of growth, EPS growth. And you can come to that conclusion in 1 minute using the color codes. Let's look at the stock's technical chart. This is DDS, Dillard's, using at a glance template. In the weekly chart, the stock was bearish with magenta color for many weeks. Even in this week where price tried to go up, the color was still magenta. At those points, if next week price starts to go down, they give us easy go with flow short trade setups. Because weekly was already magenta, the moment we have a daily candle next week that is going down from hair area, we would have a stock meeting all the unambiguous checklist conditions for go with flow trade setup, bearish trade setup. On this day, as well as on this day in the daily chart, we had such go with flow short trade setups. Weekly was already magenta, so all we needed was for the daily candles to recover somewhat, come to value area and decline again, giving us a magenta color candle. We had such candles at these two points. For both of them, we would have initial profit target at the lower boundary, and both of them hit the lower boundaries comfortably. On this candle, on this Thursday, price came to the white direction line and went up from there. Price was already at lower boundary. It also was near the memory support line. Looking at the memory support line, the white direction support line, and also the fact that it was oversold, price was near the lower boundary, one might book full profit in the swing short trades and not try to let profit run. I see in the weekly also, it came precisely to the memory support and went up from there. That would also be a reason to book full profit at the low of the week, that is 67.25, around that price range, which had multiple support levels. Using such technical support levels helps us decide when to book full profit and when to try to let profit run. In this case, for the very short trades, because we had many support levels both in weekly as well as daily charts, we would not try to let profit run but book full profit for swing short trades. We saw that for industrials, for utilities, for consumer discretionary, previous week's industry acceleration and deceleration accurately predicted future market moves. Let us study acceleration, deceleration of this week. These are the 10 most accelerating industries of this week. Four of the accelerating industries are in consumer staples. In few previous market roundups, I had mentioned that consumer staples were lagging for long time. That would be a time Q traders would start to look for possible long setups in value stocks. The three consumer staples industries that accelerated this week: brewers, packaged foods and meals and food products, actually four of them, drug retail as well. All the four consumer staples industries were weak for a long time. Therefore, if we find a value stock that is starting to go up, that will give us a possible long-term investment opportunity as well as possible swing short-term trade opportunity. In packaged foods and meals industry, I saw this stock, Dean Foods. We had discussed this stock earlier. It was a value stock. It went up by 24.6% this week. You could buy this stock using memory breakout entry technique on this Tuesday, 8th May. That trade turned out to be hugely profitable. You could take this trade confidently knowing its valuations, technical as well as industry strength. Earlier, I had discussed the memory breakout entry technique. if at price open or near price open of the day a stock breaks above memory resistance and then continues to go up, that gives us an opportunity to take a very low risk long entry using fine-tuned real-time chart. If the memory breakout happens near the close of the day, then it is too late. But if the breakout happens near the open of the day, then it gives very low risk entry opportunity using fine-tuned chart. That happened in Dean Foods DF on 8th May. Let's study the accelerating industries using QH and then look at Dean Foods using Q fundamentals as well as technicals. In QH, to identify the accelerating industries, we sort over the past 5 days column. Just double click on the column header. The accelerating industries are those that show the past 5 days score in cyan color. We have brewers, packaged foods and meats, food products, drug retail. These 4 industries accelerating are all in consumer staples sector. That sector was weak for a long time, and you can see instantly using the color coding that all these 4 industries were weak magenta for a long time and now improved score significantly. That is showing up as acceleration on the past 5 days column. Let's drill down into the packaged foods and meat stocks using scorecard. Instantly we can see this stock DF Dean Foods is optimally valued. We know that from the cyan color in valuation primary column. It pays a nice dividend of 3.44%. We would have been ready with a list of stocks like DF, which were optimally valued and in an industry that was weak for a long time, so that the moment it starts to accelerate, the industry starts to accelerate, we can start looking for low risk technical setups. That came in DF recently as it broke above memory resistance. Let's look at the technical charts. This is Dean Foods DF using at a glance template. In the weekly chart, price was creating a very nice base. This watermark support level was holding price for a long time. This week, initially price tried to go down, precisely hit the watermark support and went up from there. On this cyan color candle, Tuesday of this week, price broke all the memory resistance lines. There were multiple resistance lines before. They all got broken one after another. The last one was broken on this Tuesday, very near market open. Because it broke the memory resistance near market open, we could use fine-tuned chart to enter long at the lower end of this long candle. Probably book partial profit at upper boundary. And as the industry is accelerating, as the stock is optimally valued, as the technicals are very bullish, in this case, there would not be any reason to exit full position. Partial position may be held using trailing stop using Q protection signal. This is in contrast with the short swing trade that we discussed just a while ago in Dillard's. In Dillard's, looking at multiple supports, we would like to book full profit in the short trade. However, in case of Dean Foods, we would take a long trade, but there is no resistance, therefore we would not like to book full profit. Now we are looking at this week's decelerating industries, the 10 most decelerating industries. Remember, during sector analysis, I mentioned that though real estate was strong in recent periods, and it went up this week also, Under the hood, looking at the decelerating industries, we find four of the most decelerating industries are in real estate. That shows that it may not be the time to take new long position in this sector. If we look at keyword, we will find that not only these four industries but all the real estate industries decelerate. Let's use QH to see that. In QH, to identify the decelerating industries, we can double click the page 5 days column again. The most decelerating industries show the page 5 days score in magenta color. We can see many of them are in real estate. This one, this one, this one. If we want to look at only the real estate industries, we may go to the sector tab, go to real estate row, which shows that as a sector it decelerated. It's the most decelerating sector with the score of 1 over page 5 days column. To drill down, we can click on the drill down button. That will bring all the real estate industries in the industry panel. And now if we look at the page 5 days column, you will see all but probably one, except hotel and resort rates. Every other real estate industry decelerated heavily. That is very bearish sign for the sector as a whole, and it may not be safe to take new long trades right now in real estate. Now looking back, we can see how using sector industry acceleration, we could catch the exact turning point of real estate stocks as they were starting to go up after prolonged downtrend. And now using deceleration, we can be careful, protect our profit in long positions, and even start to look for shorts. Those are the regular topics that we cover in every market roundup. Let me go through some of the recent posts that were shared either in forum or in our social network channels. This is our Google Plus channel. I had shared one trade entry technique on Friday. That was based on this chart, US stock. This stock was very strong in the daily chart in recent period. However, at the right edge, when I took the snapshot, it tried to go above the memory resistance line, watermark resistance line, and reversed. It was already overbought as shown by the stretch dots on top of the candles. Therefore, it created a false upside breakout. It was still overbought. The bear release signal or stretch release signal had not appeared yet. At the same time, in weekly chart, it went up, hit the watermark resistance and memory resistance lines, and reversed from there. It was at multiple resistance levels in both weekly as well as daily charts. This is a very convenient chart setup to start looking for either swing short trades or short day trades. For swing short trades, we will have to wait for a proper trade setup. The trade setup was not there yet because we didn't have a bear release signal in the daily chart. If such bear release signal appeared at the end of the day, then we could consider taking a bearish short trade. In this case, looking at the weekly chart, I don't think that the weekly candle would turn yellow at that time. Therefore, strictly speaking, all the conditions of the box short trade setup would not be met, even if we had a bear release signal in the daily chart. Could we still take a swing short trade? We could probably take that if the industry was also weak and if the fundamentals of the stock were also weak at the same time. If the fundamentals are strong, then we would avoid taking an improvised trade. Not sure if you had gone through the relevant forum post. Do you happen to know what stock was this? It was Baidu. As a stock, fundamentally, Baidu is not weak, far from that. Let's have a look at the stock using Q scorecard. This is Baidu. Instantly, using primary valuation score, we see it is optimally valued. And in terms of growth, it is very strong. The last three quarters have very high positive growth, and the growth is accelerating from 63% to 129% to 137%. And the yearly periods also show accelerating earnings growth from 19% to 40% to 136%. Both in terms of valuation and growth, it is very strong, not a weak stock at all. Under such circumstances, a Q trader would try to avoid. I think it is better to avoid improvising on the technical setups. Could it be taken as a day trade? That would be all right. Day trades typically will have very small stop loss. One could try to take a day trade using the technical charts. For day trades, we probably do not need to look at the fundamentals. However, for swing trades as well as certainly for long-term investments, we keep an eye on fundamentals. Many traders say that for swing trading, it is not important to look at fundamentals. That is not true in my experience. If we use the fundamentals, just spend one more minute to check the stock's strength or weakness, then I have seen the chance of getting stopped out is much less. If we take a short trade in a fundamentally strong stock like Baidu for swing trading, the likelihood of getting stopped out is much higher. I personally try to avoid such trades. Another post that I submitted to the social network was referring to a blog. That blog essentially looked at the industry acceleration deceleration that we discussed in previous market roundup and showed how that analysis could accurately predict future industry moves. We had already discussed that in this session as well. Let me share one more trade that you could enter this week. This is a trade that I had taken and I thought it would be good to share how I decided on the entry of the trade. This is a pharma stock, pharma biotech stock, IONS, Ionis Pharma. In the weekly chart, it came to the watermark level, which was around the congestion level of March 2017. From there, price had gone up significantly. This was earnings week. Price initially tried to go down and then reversed. Remember, in today's session, we discussed another stock just like this, where price initially tried to go down and reversed, giving us a bounce long trade setup. That was 3D systems, DDD. And now we see in pharma also we have this stock where initially price tried to go down, big gap down after earnings, and immediately next day price reversed. If you look at the weekly and daily charts together, you will realize that you could take a long trade right at the beginning of this yellow candle at the lower end with a narrow stop loss, and as price went up, it easily exceeded the risk per share profit could be booked. The weekly as well as daily technicals are very strong, so half of the position could be held. You may keep an eye on the memory resistance line to see if it reverses from there. If it pierces that and continues to go up, then we like to continue to hold on to the stock using trailing stop. This was again an exhaustion based bounce trade setup. Those trades can be taken if the fundamentals are not strong, because these are very fast trades, reversal trades. Still, let us look at ION's fundamentals. No harm looking at that. Takes only 1 minute. ION's, the stock was down a lot, therefore we expect it to be of good valuation, not growth. That was true. It has strong earnings quality and it also has a short squeeze potential. So in terms of fundamentals, we had enough reasons to start looking for long trades in this stock, and that opportunity came as a bounce long trade setup. You could identify the trade by creating a watch list of value stocks and then catching the trade just as they start to go up. Let me summarize. Looking at market breadth and broad market ETFs, we see that market is bullish. All the ETFs went up. Some of them are at memory resistance level. However, there is no bearishness in any of the market indices, broad market indices or the broad market ETFs. Sectors also showed the bullishness. Most of the sectors went up, and they went up by significant percentages. We saw that there are some opportunities in industries that were weak earlier and starting to go up. Like we found Dean Foods in defensive industry. We found that real estate sector that was strong recently, it is decelerating, so it is time probably to book profit and not take new long positions right now. Market is bullish, so we may look for more bullish trades at this time. Still, we would not like to take any long trade in stocks that are overvalued or in industries that are starting to weaken, as shown by industry weakness. Like that, using Q systems, we can align all the forces in favor of our trades from market level, sector, industry, fundamentals, as well as technical levels, thereby helping us identify trades that are lower risk and higher probability. That is all that I wanted to share in today's session. Thank you for joining. I look forward to seeing you in our next session. Have a great weekend and trade profitably.